Hi, this is an oil painting I did, oh, it must be 15 years ago. I've never done anything with it. It's bigger than it looks. A lot of it's behind the mount. It was probably a half imperial or slightly less. It was very loosely based on a David Dipnell type of painting. Now, David Dipnell was one of the UK's greatest landscape painters. He manages to get a lot of atmosphere into his Hampshire landscapes, southern England, and very, very well known. Many of his works are in print. Have a look at him I'm sure he's on YouTube. He's a very well known artist, sells for a lot of money. So I'm going to do this using sponges and in acrylic. So I'm going to put that up out of the way, so I can just, I'm not going to copy it exactly. Now, using sponges, I first got onto this 25 years ago with Terry Harrison. Also, look at him on YouTube. Terry Harrison, there's double R. He used a stay wet palette and sponges with acrylic, but he would use watercolour paper. I'm sure he won't mind me showing you his demo. So that's what he did. Now, because acrylic doesn't bleed out like watercolour, you put it on wet, but it's a watercolour spreads, it diffuses all over the place. But if you use acrylic, it looks like he's used acrylic on there, unless he's blotted it out with a bit of. But what he did, what he would do, he would paint his skies in watercolour first, and then he would use his acrylics, his sponges. And this was just one of two or three demos he did in one evening for Carl Shorten and Warrington Art Club. And I bought it for £25 back then. It's a great tree. It just gives you an idea of what you can do with sponges. So I'm not painting on, well, I'm painting on watercolour paper, but I primed it with PVA glue and some burnt sienna. So, a bit of publicity for Terry. A very nice man and a very good artist. I think he's mostly oil now, but I don't know. Right, so I'm going to put in a sky and I'm not going to do any drawing. I'm going to go straight in, wet my sponge a little bit. That's why I'm not using a stay wet palette, I'm using greaseproof paper. So I want a yellow sky, slightly yellowish. So let's just put it in and build up some. Oh, it's going to shake it a bit, isn't it? But just get a covering on to start with. Once we've done this, we'll get into the distance, the distant trees. But it's going to take some covering. But a nice yellow sort of cast over this. But I don't want it to be too bitty. But it'll be what it is. Let's see if I can just stop that board from shaking in there. As this covers, I keep hitting it with my nail. We'll let it dry a bit. Might have been better space on white paper, but it's over an old watercolour, which I don't particularly like. So a bit of alizarin and a bit of ultramarine and a load of white. I'm going to put in a background. It's quite a quick process. sure it's as quick as you want it to be. It makes my wrists ache, but it's hope it's going to be worth it. I go up into the sky because I'm going to blend it all as we go along. Could use another sponge. I've got all these sponges. I'll put that one in water to soak up some salmon. Prepare it for work. I'll go slightly darker with the blue. Oh, that's not shy. I'm thinking that I might have to do this in two parts. I've got my grandson returning from Spalding up in Lincolnshire, where he's been with grandparents for a few days, but his mum's working at home today, so we'll look after him. Okay, that'll do for that. Let's go up a bit higher there. We don't want a line, we want trees to show in the cloud. I'm not sure I like this sponge. I think it's dobbing with my finger. So put that in the water. Let's get the other one. Now that is nice and wet, squeeze it out. Try my hand. Now we'll put a bit of alizarin and a bit of ochre. I'm going to mix up a field coming across here. Some of that will be behind the clumps of trees. This is more of a natural sponge. It's not a natural sponge, it's a synthetic sponge, but I bought this in my hardware shop. Look, this great big sponge here. This is similar to it. It's a decorator sponge. Holds a lot of water. It's a little bit red in there. It's a very hot summer's day. Going downhill a little bit. I'm going to put a little bit of lighter colour on up to make a slight misty effect. Okay, this is only roughing it at the moment, at this stage. A bit of blue, a bit of alizarin, a bit of white. A bit of ochre. No detail in this bit here. Right, okay, put that back in the mix, in the water, shall I say. Wet another bit of sponge. and we'll put in some black, some cad yellow, and some red. Let's start to put in. This is black cad yellow. Put some ochre in there as well, a bit of red. Let's warm it up a little bit. And we'll have that misty thing. I've got to do much more misty in there. Just a little bit too strong. Right, okay, but just in this roughing in stage. There's a bit of green in there as well. Bit of umber. See the impressionist effect you could get with all this? And we'll do some more on the left. And then I can go over this and mist it out when it starts to dry. So I'm still working from the photograph, but I want this one higher, just a bit higher, coming up into that. It's just a clump. Okay. Now we'll start to texture in some of this foreground. It's a lovely way of painting. Well, that's a bit of my ochre. I'll show you the palette. There it is. Greaseproof paper, not a stay wet palette. I'm working drier than Terry. And I can throw this away when I'm finished with it. Somebody asked how long it lasts open like this when it's not on a stay wet palette. This will stay workable for about an hour or so. Okay, so, the colours, cadmium yellow, yellow ochre, alizarin crimson, light red, ultramarine, burnt umber, black and sap green. So we'll carry on with the foreground now. So we're black, red, green, yellow. All this gives high spots on the paper, these little dabs, for sort of dry sponging later. So let's put some blue in there, blue and red. Because this is all shadow. I'm going to do the trees with a brush. I think we'll be pushing it with, I don't know. We'll see what happens. Just blues to give a coolness. Blue and red anyway. I'm going to go back on the sky in a minute and I'll just rough this in. Cooler colours, the blues. Not pure blue, I'm mixing with a bit of red. Well, that's a bit too. Okay, let's go back with the sky now. So I'll get my large bit of sponge. Okay, just dry my hand. This will be a towel, be a mat. What's that? Wye Vale Brewery. There you go. Wye. Up in Wales for me. Or the Welsh border. I think. Okay, let's go on with the sky now. So, yellowy, bit of yellow, bit of white. I shouldn't have let that. Primed it with this burnt umber. It's taking a bit of a time to build up an impasto there. Oh, that's a bit better. Sorry about the noise. Bit of light alizarin. Did I say that? That's just a bit too. What was doing now? I mean, we can make of the sky whatever we like. Let's just come over there with. The misty effect, sort of the morning fog rising. I might even put a bit of blue in there. Very, very light blue over that. Right, let's go into the darker colour in that background, trees. No, it's just too pink. But don't want it pink. Just a little bit too alizarin. Okay, coming on. Looking quite interesting now. I'll go back on the foreground for a little while. Use another bit of sponge. You need a big pot of water. Okay, so let's go in with some lighter white bits, light bits. Bit of red, bit of ochre, bit of white. Oops. put the wildflowers in a bit later. Right, get some light. Soften down there. Very delicate. Sometimes the touch is like gossamer. All the photographs of these I put on Facebook, so have a look, join in. I published the oil version of this on my homepage and it's doing pretty well. Right, now I want some fluey sort of, sorry I can't show you the mixing of this, but I haven't got a camera set up for it, so we want some light coming through here. The paper's just a little bit croggled. Just soften the edges of this as it hits the light behind. A bit of red, a bit of ochre, a bit of white. Sort of a path going through here, but not very distinct. A bit of the light down there. I wonder if Dipple does use sponges. I mean, you can get impressions of things, not by just using the sharp edge of the sponge, depending how you cut it. Alright, let's get a nice dark red, reddy blue. Okay. Put in some warmer colours. A bit of green. That's just a bit of cad yellow mixed with the sap green. Just gently touching here and there, just giving a bit of a nice detail. It's nothing really. It's just of just little bits of flicks and bits and pieces, just to make it look as if there's a lot going on in here. More green. I'll use a bit of red for my greens as well. Oh, just that hint of green. If it goes well, it's going to be very exciting. Look. Don't like that. Alright, a darker green. It's a bit of red. Make it sort of a drab green, olivey green. Still got some softening to do on those edges. shape that better. I'll save the white highlights and little bits of blue flowers later. Probably just hitting the high spots too much. Okay, let's get a bit of the shadowy colours in there now. Blue, red. Just put the shadows back in there. I think I've got a bit too much water in it. Right. Messy business with your fingers. A bit of blue, a bit of umber. More on that dark, just being behind. Those clumps here. Got a contrast going in. Right, I need to go back onto the background now, so wash my fingers and squeeze my sponges. Squeeze my sponges out. Or a sponge. Dry fingers. Right, now we want the alizarin and the blue. Change that sky a little bit. It's a bit too yellow in there, I think. Let's just bring that light down into there a little bit. Shape those trees. I think that's a little bit better. Bits of that yellow will show through. Right, now we're going with a bit of heavier blue. I'm just going to try and add some mist to some more mist and shape to these trees in here. Try and just get this softness. Still just a little bit too light. I want the alizarin in that colour for the trees, but I want it on the blue side for the coolness. Does that show? It sort of shows. Maybe I need a bit more light around there. Well, let's just go in and see if we can get a bit of light on the horizon there. Just a sort of rising. Terry Harrison would have done three of the time I've done this. Just feather out the edges on there. The mist coming through there, and it's all sort of laying in the hollows. Just here and there, just. I'll do some foreground, might as well, while I'm here. This is just trying to give an impression of a lot going on with the minimum of effort. Now, I don't know much about botany, as you can see. I'm just putting in some. Look, I'm just using the edge of the sponge just to give some that's a little bit light there, so let's just get a bit of green on there. Concentrated too much on one area there. Right, clean out the sponge. this is going to take hours to upload. I'm upgrading my broadband to super fast fibre optic for minimal cost. Unless I've misread it. For this one, it'll probably take about over 2 to 3 hours, which is just too much, really. Got a bit of alizarin in me white now, and touchy yellow. I'm going to do this here now, just to give a shape to those trees, but much lighter if I can. I'm nearly at the stage where I want to put in some trees, put the trees in. Okay, let's have it. Starting to look okay, but they're still too dark. But I'm trying not to use pure white because it's too. I want a sort of slightly bluish light. I don't want any hard edges on that. Right, I'm going to put a bit of alizarin. And a little bit of blue. Try to show you a little bit of undulations in the ground. I might even use this sponge to try to do the trees. It's not really a good idea to have mixed techniques, but okay, look, that's going to be hid. Okay, right, let's find a nice straight edge. Right, so the tree's in silhouette, so we'll have some burnt umber. Okay, right, there are enough sharp edges on here to make some sort of impression. Okay, so a bit of burnt umber and a bit of blue. Don't know if that's going to work, is it? Maybe there's a bit of wet on it. No, it's not gonna go to work. I'll go over, I'll do this a little bigger. Right, come here and see what happens. I'll put in one a bit bluish. No, that's not working. I can sponge on some leaves, some spring greens. Tim was very good at this somehow. Hey, 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 hey. Okay, that's one there. I'll shortcut that with a bit of black. Right, okay, that's. I know I tell you to hold the tip, but it's a bit difficult with this. I'm going to have to go closer to the ferrule in the brush. Now taper your trees. These are only spindly, obviously spindly sort of trees. Going down to sort of nothing, but remember some come forward, some go backwards. can't really do this fine enough. Thicken that one up a little bit. There's just not enough little tiny branches on there, little twigs. Oops. Well, we'll add some bits and pieces here. See, the problem we have with this is that this is totally alien to the sponges. But when we put the leaves on, maybe that will give it a bit of an improvement. And I'll bury the base of these trunks in some more spongy stuff. Be barbecuing tonight. 8 in April. Oh, make the most of it. Hear my wrist cracking. Take your trees off the edge. Thicken that, whoops. Got a bit thick there. So we'll have to carry that through, thicken up down here a little bit. Alright, my door's gone, so I'm going to have to leave this, I think. If I turn this camera off quickly, you'll know that a 9-year-old boy is coming upstairs. Sorry about the error in the background. Right, that's it.